Hey guys, I'm going to do a hopefully not very long update on my Anzio diorama. It may look like I've done quite a bit, but what I've done on here it only took me a morning to do because I pre-planned what I was going to do, so it was just the application. I spent the morning Thursday morning, I think it was. The last video I posted, I think, was Wednesday. I'm not 100% sure of that. Maybe Wednesday was the last video, and that would have been when you guys saw this last. It was just base paint. So Thursday morning, I spent the morning making bushes. That's these things here that you see here. There's two different kinds on here. There's horsehair, rubberized horsehair, and the old man's beard. Old man's beard is a lichen that I have that grows naturally around here. That's what it looks like there, the natural thing. It grows on all the trees, and I just pick it off and clean it up, and then I paint it and use it as bushes and shrubs and stuff like that. It looks really good when you do it. You got to do it, and then you got to pick it and then spread it out into a position that you want it to, because when it dries kind of hard, and it becomes brittle, so you can't really pose it after it's dried because it falls apart. So it's you can get it in some pretty dramatic poses if you're careful with it. So anyway, I use that, and then I use the rubberized horsehair, which is really good for like vines and embankments and stuff like that. That's what this is. This is the rubberized horsehair, and this is the old man's beard. So the old man's beard I painted like an olive green, olive brown kind of color. And the rubberized horsehair, I just use that as natural because it looks like a stick already. And then I dipped them in some thinned white glue. So the white glue that's thinned with water. And then I sprinkled this green stuff on. This green stuff is called super leaf. Basically what it is tinted sawdust. Green tinted sawdust. I dipped the either the rubberized horsehair or the old man's beard. I dip it in the white glue, and then I take it and I dip it in a pile of the super leaves, or I sprinkle the super leaves over the bush. Doing it one way or the other makes it look slightly different, so I tend to do one and then do the other method just to give it some variety. And that's pretty much what I did. I made 10 or 15 bushes, and then I let them sit for about 45 minutes. That's usually all it takes to dry. And while I was waiting for them to dry, I coated all the areas that were on the diorama. I did it in sections. Like I started here, and then I moved to another area, and then I moved to another area as I was going. So I coated this in thinned white glue using a sponge. And I sprinkled 2 millimeter, like a dark green static grass over it. And then I went back over that with a 10 millimeter, kind of a late summer burnt grass over it. So there's like patches of short and patches of long, and there's two different colors. Actually, there's like more than that, because the autumn or the late summer stuff has like three different colors in it all by itself. And I left it so it's like there's long patches and short patches. And I did that all the way around the diorama. And I did the base of the wall and the base of the steps. In here, I did all in there. And I did all the way around the house and back. I'm probably going to add some vegetation to the rear here and along the side. It's looking kind of blah to me. So I want to add something there, I think. Because there's so much detail back here, I think I'm going to add stuff there. So then once I did that, I let that dry probably maybe 4 hours, 3 hours, I think. And it wasn't intended to be that long. It only needs to dry for about 20 minutes. The only reason I let it dry that long is because I got busy doing stuff around the house. So then when I came back to it, the bushes were well dry, and the static grass was well dry. Then I added like just regular unthinned white glue to the back of the bushes, and I glued them in place around the diorama. So, and These are what I call hickey weed. I've mentioned them many times in videos. It's a friend of mine in Newfoundland sends them to me. And very generous, Rodney. Thank you, Rodney. I mention you all the time in my videos. But that's what it looks like before I do anything to it. Right? It's just a little flower that grows naturally around here. And but Rodney, he cultivates it in his greenhouse, and then he dries it, and he ends up with these huge stockpiles of the stuff. And I think he sent some to the Dutch modeling, Sebastian Schoof. In the Netherlands, he sent some to him, and now he's got some. And I find it really useful, because you can put static grass on it and make it look like a cedar or a pine of some kind. Not really an identifiable one, but it gives the aspect of one. And it's kind of what I did here. There's a couple of the pictures that I was looking at using as reference. There were trees that kind of sort of looked like that, so that's why I went with it. Then I added, these are seafoam back here. They're made from seafoam. I took them off another diorama, so I didn't really have to build them, but, you know, I've got all kinds of that stuff anyway. Sometimes I paint the seafoam first, and then I add super leaf to it. Sometimes I don't. Sometimes I do. This time I didn't. I'm thinking that maybe I should have. So I could still probably replace those if I wanted to. They're just glued in place, and it's not too hard for me to remove them. So I may change them out, but I kind of like the color, so I may leave them there. That was it. Then I just let it sit for overnight, I guess. And then this morning, very late last night and early this morning, I started working on a set of farm animals that I got in the mail, which surprised me because it got here really fast. I ordered it on Sunday and it got here on Thursday. Totally blew my mind. Normally stuff doesn't do that here. Usually, even if I order something within my own country, I could order something from my city, my capital city, which is a 45-minute drive from here. It still takes a week to get here. And I was totally surprised by it. It got here in just a few days. Very pleased. So anyway, so late last night and early this morning, I started working on those. So I got them built. They were Tamiya, so they were easy to build, easy to clean up. And so I'm sorting on which ones I want to use and which ones I'm not going to use. And they're pretty good. They got a bunch of chickens, you got a bunch of pigs, adults and baby pigs. You got a German Shepherd and a pup, a couple of ducks, an ass. I had an extra ass lying around, so I don't know how I'm going to use an ass, though, because the asses are big, and I don't know if there's room for them, so I probably won't use them. And I'm also working on some figures, too, that I haven't decided which figures I'm going to use, because I've changed the story that this is being told. You can probably tell if I turn this thing. The tiger looks, now that I've added vegetation to the roadway, the tiger looks kind of confined in that road, right? So, yeah, without the vegetation, the tiger fit fine. There was at least, I guess scale-wise, there's at least 6 to 8 inches on either side of the tiger for it to fit in the roadway. But with the vegetation on there, it seriously changed that. So it looks like it's stuck. But actually, all it's doing is just touching the bushes. And see it from behind, too. There's actually quite a bit of room, right? So, but because of the way the bushes are sitting on there, it looks like the tiger's actually stuck in there. So the story that I'm going to be telling now, hopefully anyway, if I get the figures done up, is I'm going to have a couple of guys standing here, and maybe a couple of guys standing back here, maybe a guy standing here, and they're trying to figure out, you know, whether or not the tiger can actually fit through there. And it'll look like a discussion is occurring about the positioning of the tiger. And that's the story that's going to be, you know, told, like stuck in Anzio, that sort of thing. And I may have a little like a bee story where one of the crewmen are sneaking off to try and steal some of the livestock, because pillaging the landscape for food is something that armies did on a regular basis in any war. And so this wouldn't be any different. I having all that food sitting there, it's not going to be sitting there for too long. So I was thinking about having maybe a couple of crewmen sneaking off trying to grab some of the chickens or grabbing a pig or two or something like that. So I may add that in there as well. I think I have two figures in my stash that may work on that. So it'll end up being a fairly active scene, I think, by the time I'm done with it. And again, it's going to be figure heavy, as most of my things. I can't seem to be able to stop making figures. And I hate figure painting. I hate it. I can't stand it. But I end up making all the damn figures. But anyway, so I think that's it for now. My leopard vignette is still drying, so I'm waiting on that. I can't do anything with it until that dries. So, you know, I'm just working on this for now anyway. I think that's... I can't think of anything else I wanted to say. Yeah, so I guess that's it. I can't think of anything else for now anyway. Hopefully you guys are going to have a good weekend. Enjoy yourself. Happy modeling. You guys be good. Keep your stick on the ice. Bye for now.